All right, let's put this on. Got the drill over there. Wall's ready to go. Don't know if I'm going to like this shape. I don't like it on the bench. But I think the reason why I don't like it is because it's not normal for me. So, we'll see. I'm not going to glue it because I want to look at it. And then I'll glue it. There's that ledge. Such a huge help. You move this up to the front. Just gonna put two screws so I can look, maybe three. See what kind of view you guys are getting, a terrible one. So let's go bring you over here and see what you guys think. It's definitely different for me. So, all right, well, we're gonna lay it back down and glue it. We're gonna make it work. Now I'm going to glue along here. Put it back up. These three will just hold it, and then we'll add some more. For the other side. Now what you want, you can also do, and I do recommend you do it, is you can take your cutoffs, and I got to separate these, they're still glued together. What but you put them in here and attach them, and it'll keep your wall square until you can get your spars in. Two on this wall, put two on the other, one in the front, one in the back, just to kind of keep them straight up. Measurement you took when you cut this, remember that, because that's going to be your measurement. You're going to need that measurement throughout the whole build. And that's the measurement you want, because that's the measurement you want up top to keep everything square and everywhere in between. Don't move. Walls will be relatively square until you can get your roof spars in. Now, your roof spars width-wise will be the exact same width as your floor. So, remember when I told you to remember that measurement? That's why. Alright, so now it's time to cut the roof spars to length. The easiest way I do that is what I'll do. So I'll cut one board down to the right width. And then I'll set up a jig like this on my saw. I'll put the board in there, cut one to length, drop the saw blade down, put it in there, and then I build a block for the back. So when I go to cut these, I'll throw a full 2x4 in here. Just drop it in there and make the cut. And I can do that repetitively, just over and over, and each one will be the exact same as the other. So that's why I do it that way.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to leave one full one just in case I need it for something else. This should be enough to get us started. Okay, so what I've done here is put pocket holes in all of the spars. Pocket holes in the end, both sides. Now we're ready to install them. Okay, I've also got some screws everywhere I need them for my spars. I do them 12 inches on center. The first one's going to go on the bottom. Next one. these next two are for the fan, so they got to be 14 inches apart from edge to edge. So these will be the only two that aren't 12 inches on center. Try to keep this square until I get a countertop or bulkhead in so nothing starts flapping in the wind. So that's why I re-secured that. Video. You're going to mark this edge on this edge so you can get that angle just right. You can do that on both sides. Make sure it's flat on the spar and that you're marking the same surface that's it's laying on.